In this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you a few ways on how to auto-resize shapes, which makes animating them so much easier. Hi guys, my name is Manuel. Alright, let's check out how to animate the size of two shapes using one slider control. The behaviors are obviously related to each other. In this case, it's the opposite behavior. As one gets bigger, the other one gets smaller. First of all, we create the two round shapes, of course, by double-clicking on the ellipse tool. Size 500 pixels each, which is the maximum size the shapes are going to reach. Then we duplicate the shape. No stroke, solid fill. I use two different fill colors. We want to control the animation with one slider. So let's add a null object. Then go to Effect, Expression Controls, Slider Control. Next, we open the slider control property and right-click on slider. Choose edit value and set the two value to 500. The size of the two shapes. Now, we somehow need to link both size properties to that slider. Let's add an expression to the first size property. We establish a variable, s like size equals, then we select the null and use the property pickwhip to link the size property to the slider control. So s is like the number the slider indicates, semicolon. And this number is one part of a two-dimensional value. The scale value has two dimensions, square brackets, and in the square brackets, s, s, semicolon. We simply use it twice. Awesome, the slider controls the size of the shape. To control the size of the other shape as well, we copy and paste that expression to the other size property. Both size properties behave exactly the same. To make them behave in the opposite way, we need to add 500 minus the maximum size to one of the two variables. Awesome, so the size properties behave like we want them to. Let me quickly undo the position change. Now we need to adjust the anchor points. We add an expression to the anchor point property. Then add a equals source rectangle time semicolon. And in square brackets, a dot left plus a dot width. Divided by 2, comma a dot top. Which pins the anchor point to the top center at all times. For the other shape, we need to pin it to the bottom center. We add an expression to the anchor point property, a equals source rectangle time, semicolon, and in square brackets, a dot left plus a dot width, divided by 2, comma a dot top, plus a dot height. And the anchor point is pinned to the bottom at all times. That's it. One slider controls the size of both shapes. And if you switch the positions, you can put them in a box. Let's take a quick moment and check out an amazing in-depth animation course by Domestika. In this course, you'll learn how to create expressive typography in motion with After Effects. Design letter forms in Illustrator and animate them in After Effects. Start with research and references, color, then design a lettered phrase in Illustrator. In After Effects, animate it using kinetic typography. I've added the link to the course in the description. And even better, use the code MANUEL_MOTION10 for an extra 10% off. Instead of round shapes, you can use squares as well. Of course. Just like before, there are two shapes, the size controlled by one slider, which are animated. You could do more though. Let's duplicate the top shape and position it on the lower edge of the bottom shape. Then let's alter the size value in the expression. S, s means we take both values as they are. But you could, let's say, multiply the first s by 2, which doubles the x value. Or instead of using a variable, you could simply add a number. Let's say 50 for the Y value, which means the height is 50 pixels. Awesome, right? So one more thing. Why did I use the size property of the shape and not the scale property? Because if you want to use a stroke, the stroke width would be scaled as well. You could use the scale property, of course. Simply add the two expressions to the scale properties of the layers instead of the size properties of the shapes. And you need to change 500 minus into 100 minus, of course. You scale the two objects between 0 and 100. So the tool value of the slider control would be 100. Download the free project file to check it out in detail. Let's fit the size of an object to the height of another one. We double click on the rectangle tool to create the large shape. Height, 500 pixels. Width, very wide. Fill white, no stroke. Let's create the round shape by double clicking on the ellipse tool. Fill black. And we have a circular shape inside. Size 500 by 500 pixels. So if we increase or decrease the height of the rectangle, we want the circular shape to fit to it. Both anchor points are exactly in the center, by the way. That's important. So let's use the scale property this time. We add an expression to the scale property of the round shape. Then let's establish two variables. X equals, we use the pick whip tool to get the X scale value. Y equals, we get the Y scale value. Then let's put the value together. Square brackets, and inside we use the Y value or height twice, as we want it to fit to the height. If we change the height of the rectangle, the size of the round shape adjusts automatically. One more thing. Let's duplicate the shape, move it below, change the fill color, and alter the scale value. We multiply both dimensions by 1.5. You could add a set matte effect. Take the matte from the rectangle. So in some cases, few expressions make it much easier to animate shapes. Make sure to check out the links in the description. On the left side, I've added some videos you might like. Subscribe to my channel on the right side and hit the bell, cause you don't want to miss my next video. Thanks for watching this one. See you in the next one. Bye, guys.